Good morning, Evans. I am Mr. Cutsforth, and here is the Bulldog broadcast for Friday, February 2nd, 2024. Today is cycle day one. On the lunch menu for today, in the main lunch lines, we are having mini corn dogs, potato smiles, and pears. Also available is the pizza line, the bento box, and the salad bar option. Here are some fun facts. Did you know, according to a recent research, the human nose can distinguish at least a trillion different odors? And the different colors of Fruit Loops cereal all taste the same? They're not individual flavors. And what's inside a Kit Kat, you ask? Broken Kit Kats that are damaged during production. They get grounded up and go between the wafers on the inside, along with the cocoa and sugar. And Flaming Hot Cheetos were developed by a janitor at Frito-Lay. Well, he got the idea after putting chili powder on some rejected Cheetos and then pitched it to the CEO. I don't like Cheetos, so if you do, there you go. Now you know. It's that time again. That's right. It's time to gaze toward the state of Pennsylvania and watch a little groundhog scurry out of his den. Because being released to let the masses know when to expect a break in winter weather and how soon they will see the spring breezes flow. A groundhog predicting the weather? That's right. After the United States made the day an official holiday, Clymer H. Fraze was the editor of the Punxsutawney Spirit, a local newspaper in Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania. He began the Herald, the town groundhog, as the official Groundhog Day meteorologist. He began the branding certainly worked, because when most people heard about this day, now who pops in mind? That's right, none other than Punxsutawney Phil. But how accurate is this furry little creature? Well, there is some debate over that, but dear old Phil, the professionals say that he is correct about 39% of the time. Sadly, that means he isn't correct even 50% of the time, so the odds are probably more in favor of flipping a coin than really listening to Phil. It's a fun tradition, though. In Evans sports, 8th grade boys and girls basketball teams are playing catch-up because of the weather. On Tuesday, the boys raced past Fort Madison by the score of 50-11. The girls have also gotten off to an impressive start this season. They also played Fort Madison, spanking the Bloodhounds by the score of 50-6 on Tuesday afternoon. Their games will continue next week on Monday against Keokuk, Tuesday, February 6th versus Mount Pleasant, and Thursday, February 8th against Washington. The Evans archery teams were also out in full force at the Eddyville tournament last Saturday. And once again, this group dominated the competition by taking home the first place trophy in both the block and 3D. Here are the results. Continue your success, shoot straight, and may your arrows never be bent. Make sure that you get out and support our student athletes. Go Bulldogs! Today in history for February 2nd, in 1887, the first Groundhog Day observed at Gobbler's Knob, Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania, of course. And in 1922, the time was 2-22-22 on the date of 2-22-22. And in 1959, Buddy Holly's last performance at Surf Ballroom in Clear Lake, Iowa. And in 1964, G.I. Joe debuts as a popular American boys toy. And in 2020, Super Bowl 54, who can forget, the Kansas City Chiefs beat the San Francisco 49ers 31-20. Your MVP was Patrick Mahomes, Kansas City Chiefs quarterback, and it was the first Super Bowl victory for Kansas City in 50 years. And what a coincidence, they play again next week in the next Super Bowl. unbelievable. Go Niners. Hashtag ring for George. The deadline to purchase a yearbook is Friday, February 16th. The cost is $25 and can be purchased in the main office. No late payments will be accepted. Here are your Evans Students of the Week for January 29th through February 2nd. Congratulations, and continue to show your Evans pride. Your Evans Show Choir, Supernova, performed at OHS this weekend in front of a packed house and were absolutely amazing. Here is a clip of their performance. Special thanks to Mr. Stone, Ms. DeBoer, Ms. Russell, Ms. McCoy, and Mr. Canny, as they all chipped in their musical talents to play the music for the show choir. Another big thank you to Maya, Kennedy, and Oceana for their time spent with the sixth grade choir show choir members over the last 2 months to get them ready as well. If you miss Sweets and Sounds, you can find Supernova on their Midwest tour starting February 10th in Keokuk. Great job to all of you. Yearbook Club will meet Monday, February 5th at 3:30 in the main office. Evans Middle School will be doing a culture and climate activity as the school. We will be spreading some love to the community by doing a drive for Heartland Humane Society. This will run from Monday, February 5th through Friday, March 1st. Students can bring cat food, dog food, and other items to donate, cat and dog bands, or toys for animals. There will be competitions between advisory classes, like you see the ones that are scrolling, with prizes for the winners. A list of needs and categories is attached. Staff, you will be having a monetary donation competition between the 7th and 8th grades. A list of competitions prizes is also being scrolled through as well. Make sure you look at those. A specific building goal competition will be announced later, but has a great reward being planned out. It's just a surprise for now. So make sure you're bringing in your treats, all your toys for those animals, the cats and dogs. Have a great day, Evans. Teachers, please lead your students in the Pledge of Allegiance. We made it through a full week of school. Stay classy, Evans.